How are you, learners? Welcome to our lesson in Form 1. My name is Mr. Joha. We want to start another topic where we are going to look at the topic of mass, weight, and density. And in this case, we will define mass and density in this topic. So our objectives should be that the learner should be able to find the mass and weight. You should first of all be able to define and then find mass and weight. Suppose you are given any of the two. Now, what is mass? Want straight away to go and look at what means the term mass. Now, mass of an object is the quantity of matter in it. The quantity of matter in it. So quantity means the particles that that matter contains. That is its mass. So mass is constant. Anywhere you go, mass remains constant. Why? Because it is the number of the particles that are contained in that particular object. So if the object is containing 1 million particles, then wherever you take that object, you will still remain with 1 million particles. So mass will remain constant everywhere you go. The SI unit of mass is kilograms. SI unit of mass is kilograms. There are other units. There are other units apart from kilogram. There are other units that they also can measure mass. And you want to look at the conversion of those other units. One ton, which we call it as a megagram, is equal to 1,000 kilograms. We all know a ton. Okay? So 1 ton is equal to 1,000 kilograms. And 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams. Then 1 gram is equal to 1,000 milligrams. So that means 1 kilogram will have 1 million milligrams. So 1 milligram is the same as 0.00001 kilograms. We can use those conversions in our calculations wherever the conversion is needed. An example is like this one. Omar needs 21,000 kilograms of sand to construct his house. How many lorries of sand will he buy? If one lorry carries 7 tons of sand, he needs 21,000 kilograms of sand to construct his house, but the sand will be carried in lorries, and each of the lorries carries 7 tons of sand. So how many lorries will he need to be able to have 21,000 kilograms? And this is how it goes now. Okay, one lorry is equal to 7 tons. We can make it in tons, so 7 tons. Then the sand he needs is 21,000 kilograms. How many tons are this? So we divide that one by, we know, 1 ton is equal to 1,000 kilograms. So we can divide this one by 1,000 to make it in tons. So 21,000 divided by 1,000, that will give us 21 tons. So in other words, how many lorries does he need? He needs the number of lorries will be the same as 21 tons divided by 1 ton. The amount of mass for one lorry is 7 tons. And so he needs 3 lorries to be able to give him 21 tons. 3 lorries. So you can see how we can use the conversion for our calculation, a real life calculation. Example 2. Salma bought four two-thirds kilograms of meat. Half of the meat was cooked, and a quarter of the remainder was used to make burgers for the following day's breakfast. How much meat in grams was left? So he had 4 kilograms and 2/3 of a kilogram of meat. Half of that was cooked, then the other 1/4 of that, of the remainder, was used to make burgers. Now we go ahead and try to look at this. First of all, we need to calculate the cooked meat. How much was cooked? We are told it is half cooked. It's a half of the total amount of meat, which was 2 3/3. Of means multiplication. So we are going to take a half multiplied by 4 2/3. 4 2/3, we make it in an improper fraction. That is going to be 12 14 14 over 3. So in other words, this is going to give us 7 over 3 kilograms in terms of improper fraction. So that is the much that was cooked. And how much remained there? It is this one. The one which was cooked was a half of the total meat. The remaining was also a half of the total meat. So the remaining was again 7 over 3 kilograms. That is the much that remained. So the remainder, taking the amount of meat that was cooked, the remainder was 7 over 3 kilograms. So, burgers. Burgers was 1/4 of what remained. 1/4 of what remained was made burgers for breakfast. So we can take the burgers so that we get what was left. So burgers was 1/4. 1/4 of, multiplication is the symbol for of, over 7 over 3. So that is going to give us 7 over 12 for burgers, 7 over 12 kilograms. That is for burgers. Now, what was left? We have used a half for cooking. We have used 7 over 12 for burgers. So how much has been left? So we need to take the total amount of meat. We subtract what has already been used. A half and a 7 over 12. So the leftover of the meat, the leftover of the meat will be the same as taking the total amount of meat, which is 4 2/3. We subtract what has been used. What has been used is 7 over 3 plus 7 over 12. This is what has been used. So if we subtract that, we are seeing that we change this into improper. 14 over 3 will subtract what we have there. 7 over 3 plus 7 over 12 will give us 21, it will give us 35 over 12. So 14 over 3 minus 35 over 12, that is going to give us 21 over 12. So in other words, what was left is 21 over 12. But our question is asking us, how much kilograms, how much grams, because this is in kilograms, 21 over 12 is in kilograms. Then how many grams are these? How many grams are these? And we know our conversion again tells us that 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams. So we are going to take that much and we multiply it by, so 21 over 12 kilograms. We want to make it to grams, therefore we multiply this one by 1,000. So how much is it that will give us in grams? So that is going to be the same as 1,750 grams. That means 21 over 12 is giving us 1.75 kilograms, which we multiply by 1,000, and that will give us 1,750 grams. And so from this conversion of mass and the calculations, we can be able to calculate mass and all that. So we will look at a weight in our next video, so be around so that you don't miss that part.